Hey, what's up, guys? Jerry here. So first things first. This video I think is not gonna have any kind of like background recording, mostly because I don't really record myself playing games anymore. And also I don't remember how to use Adobe Acrobat Premiere. So I'm just gonna upload this thing as is. Unfortunately, that means it's just gonna have the audio for this one, but that's all right. That's okay. I tell myself that, but that's probably just cope. So what's been going on? Well, I noticed I have not uploaded in 2 years. A part of that is because I got really busy with my grad school program and furthering my career. A part of that is because I fucking forgot that I have a YouTube channel. I actually completely forgot this thing is even here, which is kind of weird because I use YouTube almost every single day. Like I watch RuneScape videos on a daily basis. I look up music. I look at League of Legends highlights. I watch all of Charlie's videos. I don't know. I just forgot. Sorry. So really, but really more than anything, what is this video gonna be? Well, it's mostly kind of a pretty major milestone in my life. For many of you guys, as you guys know, I've been going to this grad program for about 4 years now, and I actually defended my dissertation last Thursday, October 20th. It went very well. I was actually kind of surprised how much I knew, but I guess in some ways, paying for grad school, I'm glad I learned something. I mean, the money didn't go to waste. But yeah, I mean, it was really nice. It was really nice. We had a lot of people turn up for that. I was actually kind of surprised how many people ended up showing up. So I was really happy the amount of support I was able to get from that. But it was really cool because so that weekend I FaceTimed with my parents, and it was such a good experience because my dad was very proud of me. My mom was very proud of me. She's actually crying over FaceTime, which I didn't really expect that. But yeah, no, it was such a good feeling knowing that I've made them proud. 'Cause I think for many of us, that's really kind of our goal is to make our parents proud. And it was so heartwarming to kind of do that, to show them that, yeah, I've learned a lot. I'm quite good at what I do, I guess. But no, more than anything though, I mean, it was just nice just seeing how proud they were of the things I've been able to accomplish, and hopefully in the future I keep accomplishing more and more things as I move on to my professional career. One thing that's always been kind of fascinating to me is when I was a kid, I couldn't ever imagine working a full-time job. If you guys remember, for many of you OG viewers of this channel, do you remember when I first started working? There was a period of time I was working at like Bed Bath and Beyond. I was working like part-time in an MRI center. I was doing like laboratory research with mice and rats. I was miserable. Like some of those videos I was producing at that time. I mean, I don't have those videos anymore, so maybe my memory is just a little bit far off. But I definitely remember like recording those videos. Like, yeah, this is not my best content I've ever put out there, because I was just tired all the time. And I think it's so different being in a field, working as a psychologist, and actually really enjoying what I do. So, right now I currently manage a caseload of about two patients for neuropsychology. We do neuropsych assessments with them. And then I see about 3 to 4 patients on a weekly basis for psychotherapy. Now, these are different types of psychotherapies. For some patients, I'll do like process-oriented approach. Some people I'll do like more cognitive behavioral. Some people there's like a more of assessment, not assessment, acceptance and commitment therapy sort of thing. So it really depends on the person, what their kind of needs are. So it's actually kind of different in many different ways, where on one hand I have more of the assessment experience from the standard neuropsych, more related to cognitive neurology, more related to kind of the medical aspect of human cognition. And then you have the other aspect of strictly just, oh, sorry, for some reason, I don't know why this thing just like turned off on its own. It like tabbed out. That was kind of weird. But yeah, so then the other half of it is just strictly psychotherapy, which I never thought I would enjoy. I'm actually having a good time with it. I really am. So it's very interesting. Just kind of like the dynamics that are going on there. And more than anything, I'm more or less surprised. But Anyways, I'm going off track, but all this comes around because, when I was a kid, I couldn't imagine enjoying work. Like, why would you want to give someone your free time? Well, for one, you get fucking paid for it, which is quite nice. But the other part of it is, fulfillment. That's really something that's really surprised me is finding that, yeah, this is definitely psychology. This is it. Like, this is what I enjoy. And I go into work, it doesn't feel like work. The entire day just goes by so quickly. Of course, that's not to say, it's not exhausting. There's definitely some days where I just feel tired, but there's not a single day where I come home from work where I thought, oh my gosh, this sucks. This actually blows. As strange as it sounds, when I drive into work, I am fucking pumped for the day to get started. But also, when I'm leaving work, I'm pumped to get home. Because, hell, we all need our free time at the end of the day, don't we? So yeah, that's kind of cool. But ultimately, it's like if you talk to me a few years back, if again, this really comes back to a lot of you guys who used to watch my videos from like 2015, 2016. I was really having a lot of a hard time during that period of time. I'm not denying that. My mental health was horrible. I was graduating from college. I had no idea what I want to do with my life. I felt so lost in life of like what my purpose was. And I'm really glad I was able to find it. And I hope, for all of you guys who are watching now, I hope you find your purpose as well, because quite frankly, it is a good feeling. Not only does it boost your confidence, but it feels like, it's fulfilling that you have a purpose in this world in some way, shape, or form. So that was really cool. And ultimately it surprises me because as I have moved further away from video games, I've moved further away from that sort of thing. I kind of just lost track of it. And in some ways I wish that maybe I did dedicate more time to YouTube, dedicate more time to streaming. If Do you guys remember when I tried to stream for 365 days consecutively? I think I only got to like day 100 something and I just stopped. Oh man, I guess I really have some problems with commitment there. But yeah, I mean it's it is what it is, I guess. But yeah, it's kind of fascinating looking back on just even my time on YouTube. I mean, I had I think around 6,000, 7,000 subscribers. It was kind of weird too because when I started playing Final Fantasy 14, and then I recently recovered in April my Guild Wars 2 account from 2012. I haven't played that game since 2012. Yeah, I literally bought it when it came out. I played it for like a month on like a shitty laptop during college, and I just never touched the game ever again. It was so weird being recognized by people. So I don't know if it's just like there's like a similar circle of people who play the same types of video games or. Because I was never like huge on YouTube by any means. I was simply just known within like this tiny Terra circle more than anything. So that always kind of surprised me, and it still kind of still does even now. But yeah, I mean ultimately, especially for like video games, I wish I had more time. If I was superhuman and I could create more time, I would be able to, I would do everything. But unfortunately, I don't know if it's because I've just gotten older, I've prioritize things that are more important to me or what, but that's just not really a priority anymore, I really wish I could make more YouTube videos and maybe like build up my brand, but I mean, when I was a kid and when I was like a young adult, like that was super important to me. Like subscriber count was super important to me, but like now it's just like I don't know if it's like I'm not creative anymore or what, but I don't really have a lot of interest in making videos anymore. Not even like, no, I'm not even talking about like guys. I'm just talking about like even random videos like these. Like I don't, these aren't things I think about. I'm not writing up drafts for, ideas that I have and like recording videos. I just don't really find that interesting anymore. I don't know. So unfortunately, it's really hard for me to say what I'm gonna do in the future, especially with this channel. Probably nothing. I think really more likely the outcome, what's gonna end up happening is I'm just gonna forget this channel existing. I hope that doesn't happen, but regardless, the Jerry or I guess for some of you guys know me as Thoughtbound, I don't think that's ever gonna make a comeback in my life. And I think, in some ways, it's probably a good thing because I think a lot of people hated me during that period of time. So, good riddance to Jerry, thank God. And I do agree. I think in many ways, my relationship with YouTube in a lot of ways was pretty unhealthy during that period of time. But I think a part of it is also because, I really had nothing going on in my life, so that was really kind of my purpose. Like, oh, this is what I can do, and I find validation from other people. And then as I got older, I started realizing that, yeah, I don't really need validation from people online. Like, these are people that live like across the world from me, people living in like Bolivia and like in Europe and stuff like that, like talking shit. Like, it doesn't really matter. So yeah, I mean, it just, I stopped having a reason to really try to get approval from people online anyways. I'm doing well in real life, so that's more enough validation for me. So that's good enough. But yeah, I just remember there was like some weird people. Like, I remember there's this one dude on Terra. I think his name was Goku. Like, actual, just like straight up, just I get that man. Let's just say that man's got more problems than one. But yeah, it's like really trying to like be or try to be friends with everyone, and then you realize, oh, wait a minute, all these people are actually just here for the drama, like they couldn't care less. And I mean, I think ultimately that's really what kind of a lot of video game communities are sort of like. Depending on who you are, I guess that also kind of takes into account that too. But it's just like, it doesn't really matter at the end of the day. Like, the stuff that you do online really does not matter in the grand scheme of things. So yeah, unfortunately, the long-winded answer is I have no idea. I don't think I'm ever gonna like be big in YouTube ever again. Like, I'm just not too interested in that stuff anymore. It's actually one of the reasons why I ended up deleting this channel in 2018. I don't remember how YouTube works. I don't know if they change it now, but basically what I did at that time was I literally went into my profile and there was an option to delete channel, and I think it just instantly wipes every single video you ever have. And I just clicked that. I didn't even think twice about it. I'm like, yeah, all right, bye. I'm out. Yeah, so I guess that's maybe bad news. I don't know. I mean, I think it's good news. I think we all need to kind of move on in life, don't we? Because if you don't, you kind of get stuck, okay? I don't think anyone really wants to get stuck in life. You're going through loops and stuff like that. That's no fun for anyone. But I guess, in some ways, Terra players are still stuck because I think people play like private servers now. Like, guys, the game is dead. Like, move on. There's better stuff to do with your time. Like, come on now. I remember when actually that's a good transition. I remember when Terra shut down. So I remember someone, I think it was Lauren or maybe it was someone else in my Discord. They like linked me to the page of Terra shutting down and stuff like that. And there's people on the Terra page saying, "Oh my God, Terra changed my life. It saved me." It's like, dude, shut the fuck up. It is quite literally a video game. Kind of reminds me of that one meme where it's like that one dude that's like, "You changed my life" or something. Like one of those rage comics, I think, memes. And it's like this other thing. It's like, I'm literally just this and this. Like, that's Terra. Like, it is literally just a game. It did not change your life. It didn't make you a better or worse person. It is quite literally a game that you played to pass the time. And I think that's really what things should be. Like, that's just kind of the reality of it. So, I again, I just, Terra players, move on. But that's not the point of this video, though. Yeah, I mean, that's really kind of all that's kind of been going on in my life. I'm hoping for bigger and better things moving forward. I guess the biggest thing right now is I'm in the process of applying to postdoctorate positions, because ultimately my goal in life is to get enough money to open up my own clinic. I'm gonna hire my best friend. He is also a psychologist. We're gonna work together. That's gonna be fucking awesome. But you need a lot of money. You need a lot of name recognition because of that. So that's really kind of like the end goal right now. I don't know how long it's gonna take, frankly. Hopefully, like within the next 10 years, even. I think that'd be ideal. But right now I'm applying to postdoc positions. Thinking about moving back to Boston. I'm actually in Pennsylvania right now. So maybe going back to Boston would be pretty good. Which is kind of weird thinking about it because if you guys remember, again, for all you OGs that used to watch this channel back then when I actually had videos on this channel, in like 2016, 2017, when I was like really having a lot of problems with my mom living at home, things of that sort, loss of direction in my life, yada yada yada, I ended up making a video about how big of a struggle this is of like, what to do, and I ultimately ended up moving to Boston for about 4 years. And I didn't necessarily particularly like the city. I'm not really like a big city person, but certainly, it's really kind of opened my eyes to a lot of different experiences. So certainly I'm not against the idea of going back because at least I know like all the roads, I know all the cool places to go, hang out and stuff like that. Some of my friends from grad school are going back there, so that's gonna be kind of cool. At least I'll have a foundation and like a base there. That'd be nice, but we'll know. We'll see. I guess at this point in my life where it's like I'm 28 years old, like I have so much time ahead of me. Of course I say that, knock on wood, and I get like getting a freak accident tomorrow and I die. You never know. But no, that's really fucking morbid, I'm sorry. You never know. Like, it's sometimes you just gotta kick back and just let life carry you where you end up, you're where you end up. So I'm hoping for the best. But yeah, I mean, that's really about it for me, guys. Hope you guys are doing well. Stay healthy. Stay lovely. Love all y'all. Take care of yourselves. And I feel like the last time I uploaded one of these videos, I think I ended it by saying, like, I'll see you when I see ya. That's unfortunately gonna be the truth moving forward. I don't know what I'm gonna upload next, but people that know how to reach me know how to reach me. Take care, and yeah, see y'all. Bye.
Hold on to what you try to be, your individuality. When the world is on your shoulders, just smile and let it go. If people try to put you down, just walk on by, don't turn around. You only have to answer to yourself. Don't you know it's true what they say?
Anything you've been thinking of when the world seems to get too tough.